Welcome to Declassifying the Paranormal. Here we reveal the secrets that sinister organizations attempt to conceal from the world, objects and entities that could shake the very foundations of what we think is, and is not, possible. Today we have secured documents belonging to the SCP Foundation, and will reveal to you the nature of SCP-4646.
Item number, SCP-4646.
Object class, safe.
Special containment procedures December 30, 2059. Due to the ongoing XK class end of the world scenario, containment of SCP-4646 is a low priority.
Agent Cartwright has been assigned to containment due to his experience with temporal anomalies and because his present physical state does not enable him to aid Protocol Fallen Star.
His only duties are to limit public knowledge of SCP-4646 in order to prevent any panic among the civilian population. Due to the nature of its effects, no personnel born before December 31, 1981 are to enter SCP-4646. Description: SCP-4646 is an abandoned house in the town of Blue Fox, Montana. SCP-4646 was constructed at some point in the mid-1950s. But due to the loss of records in the Scarlet Knights of 2042, the precise date is unknown. Blue Fox is a town of 212 inhabitants, most of these possess some knowledge of SCP-4646's anomalous properties. When entering SCP-4646 between 1700 hours on the 31st of December and 6 o'clock on the 1st of January of any year, all individuals will travel through time to the house as it was at the corresponding time on 31st of December 1999 and 1st of January 2000. Exiting SCP-4646 at any point or staying until the end of the activation period will return the individual to the corresponding time in their own era. Within SCP-4646, the scene is usually described as a large New Year's party intended to celebrate the advent of the millennium. While within SCP-4646, all individuals will find their physical condition and clothing altered to resemble their state on 31st of December 1999. This does not affect other items brought into SCP-4646. Despite the large numbers of people from the last 60 years who have been within SCP-4646 during its period of activation, no overcrowding has ever been reported or experienced. The circumstances surrounding SCP-4646's creation were unknown until December 27, 2059, when Blue Fox resident and former member of the now-defunct Are We Cool Yet?
Stacy McIntosh confessed her involvement to Agent Cartwright. No further action is deemed necessary. Addendum 1, the following is a log of an interview between Agent Cartwright and Stacy McIntosh. Date, December 30, 2059. Location: Agent Cartwright's residence, Blue Fox, Montana. Interviewed, Ms. Stacy McIntosh. Interviewer, Agent Frank Cartwright. Begin log.
Hey, Stacy.
Hey, Frank. How's the leg holding up?
Yeah, very funny. Thanks for doing this.
Sure, nothing else planned. Not sure why you're still doing this, though.
Honest to God, neither am I anyway. First question.
Shoot.
When did you first, make the house like it is?
On the night itself. 1999. I was 18, barely affiliated with AUC, but I'd been doing little projects for a year. My sis and I, we thought it'd be fun. Don't know if it was art as such, but we knew how to use the flow to shift the impart around.
You thought it'd be fun? That was it?
Sure. I mean, it wasn't that hard to access the flow, and it's quite simple, really. Just a bit of time alteration. Didn't require me to think through anything deep. It was all fun and games, until we were in there.
Not a good party?
Hey, you could say that. Mind if I smoke?
Amazed you've lasted as long as you have, breathing that shit in. Go ahead. Not like I'm going to be here long enough for it to hurt me anymore.
Nah, don't talk like that, Frank.
Ms. McIntosh lights a cigarette and begins to smoke.
The party was fine. Great, even. Loads of people, but I'd made it so it always seemed like the perfect number for whoever was there. It was amazing. People had clearly heard about the party, and they'd brought all sorts of shit for us in the past. Music from the future, weird alcohol, phones from years before they were a thing. I saw a dozen identical versions of a dozen people I know. It was wild. At first.
What happened?
I met someone. Someone I knew. Dave, from down the grocery store.
I know Dave. Good guy.
Yeah. Well, you weren't there when we were young, but he used to be the life and soul of any party. I met a bunch of versions of him that were. But then I met another one, who was all quiet and sad. Said he came from, well, from now. 2059.
Well, good to know whatever token efforts to contain this thing I was going to try don't work.
Not sure that wouldn't be a good thing, Frank. He told me that every time he came in, he tried to find people from the future. Himself from the future. And they stopped in 2059.
A long silence ensues for several minutes.
Do you have family out at? I mean, I have contacts, I can see if.
I don't think your contacts are around anymore.
Yeah.
What happened? With the world, I mean? We only get bits of information here. Being civilians and all that.
I don't know much more than you. I lost my leg in the Scarlet Knights, and they shipped me out here. Things just got worse. That happens, sometimes. Eldritch horrors, things the Foundation made, death cults, or people just being people. Not sure there was ever going to be just one thing that killed us.
Yeah. I just.
I know. But it doesn't help to know.
Yeah.
Another long silence ensues.
Stars are bright tonight.
I suppose there was never that much light pollution here, even before it all started. But there would have been enough. I like to look outside and pretend it's long ago. When we were children, we could never see the Milky Way, but I remember our parents used to tell me about what the sky looked like.
You're Irish, right? I always thought the sky was clearer in Ireland. Things always seemed nicer over there.
Not in Dublin. Maybe out west.
Weird they told you it used to look like that if you could just drive over there.
Distance felt different to us. And besides, people used to say all kinds of shit back then.
Remember how much they hated millennials?
Oh God.
Hee hee hee. Those were the days.
Yeah. They really were.
Agent Cartwright lets out a long sigh.
Won't be many stars to see soon. Or people to see them.
Well, that's what the party's for.
What do you mean?
Something that always bothered me was how easy the flow came for something that wasn't art. It's doable, but usually you have to justify it somehow. Make it feel like art when you move it. But with the party, it was so easy. It was years before I realized why.
It's a testament, I guessed.
Yeah. All the years. All the people growing up and moving out, finding jobs and lives way away or staying put in their hometown. Coming back to 1999 and remembering when they were young. When it was the edge of the millennium and life had so much promise. You look out of the windows, and well, I never thought I'd feel nostalgia for an empty sky. It was art, in its own way. A remembrance of a dying world for when it was still young.
You sure got away with words, Stace.
Shut it, Frank. You gonna come tomorrow, or try to stop us?
I think. I'll put in an appearance. Would be nice to would be nice.
End log.
Addendum 2, at 1704 on December 31, 2059. Stacy McIntosh and Agent Cartwright tendered SCP-4646.
At 1709, the flowers began to bloom.
Thank you for tuning in. We hope that you enjoyed this broadcast. If you did, please subscribe, like, and share it around. If you have any particular case files you'd like us to cover in future broadcasts, leave a comment below and we'll get around to it shortly. Tune in again tomorrow for more revelations.